Hello friends, myself Preksha Parikh from LJIT. Subject is heat transfer. Chapter is convection. And today topics are coefficient of thermal expansion means beta, Grashof number means GR, and dimensional analysis applied to free convection heat transfer. Now first we take the data of coefficient of thermal expansion and Grashof number. Now what is the coefficient of thermal expansion? So characteristics are these parameters are used in free convection. So now coefficient of thermal expansion, what is coefficient of thermal expansion? So it is a property which comes into play of the free or natural convection is called coefficient of thermal expansion, which is only depends on change of temperature. So we note denoted by coefficient of thermal expansion. Okay, now how do we find out? So beta is equal to 1 upon small v into dv by dt, where pressure will be constants. Now we know that from the first law of thermodynamic, PV is equal to, if mass is constant, so RT. So now V is equal to V upon M, means small v is equal to RT upon P, which is we know that. Okay, so here simple. Small v is equal to RT upon P. Then dv by dt in the present of P. So T. So what is the derivation of T? It's a 1. So its a value is RP. So small v is equal to RT by P. And dv by dt with a constant pressure value is RP. So here we put the value 1 upon V. So here we write down P upon RT into R upon P. Okay. So RR is cancelled, PP is cancelled. So our answer beta is equal to 1 upon T. So beta is a depends of the temperature, change of temperature means. So we can write down the thermal coefficient of thermal expansion beta, which is a proportional to inverse of temperature and which is a play role in natural convection. Now Grashof number. So what is the definition of Grashof number? Grashof number means it is a product of inertia force and buoyancy force to the square of the viscous force, and its equation is L cube g beta delta t upon mu square. Now L is a characteristics length, delta t which is a difference of temperature, surface temperature minus fluid temperature, where Ts and T infinitives are the temperature of the surface and temperature of the surrounding fluid. Okay, G is a gravitational force, mu is a kinematic viscosity, beta is a thermal expansion coefficient. So we can find out the GR, which is already we find out in previous video. Now Nusselt, we know that Nusselt number is a function of Grashof number and Prandtl number. So C equal to GR raised to N and PR raised to B. Okay, so A and B both are the constants value. Another new relationship is a Rayleigh number, and Rayleigh number is a product of the Grashof number and Prandtl number. Okay, now where the in the laminar flow, the product of the GR and PR is less than 10 raised to 4 and greater than 10 raised to 9. And here the for the turbulent flow, it is the product of GR PR is always greater than of the 10 raised to 9. Okay, now the value of the GR and PR are evaluated at the mean film temperature. TF is equal to TW plus T infinity divided by 2. Now we find out the equation. So theory next here is a dimensional analysis applied to free convection heat transfer. Now we know that the heat transfer coefficient H. So we can write down H is a function of rho L mu Cp K beta G delta T. Here we take the one group beta G delta T. So here change is that it's not depends on the fluid velocity because of it is a free convection. So it is not depends on the kinematic energy, but it's a depends on the group of the beta G delta T. Okay. Now what is the delta T? So delta T is a temperature difference between the heated surface and surrounding fluid. Beta is a coefficient of a thermal expansion. Then G, acceleration due to the gravity. So beta G delta T is a considered one factor, physical factor, and its dimensions are, we can write down in MLT form, so L T raised to minus 2. Now others parameters MLT forms are here. Now first heat transfer coefficient H, which is write down here, then fluid density rho, then tube diameter or length, we can here take the L length because of we use the L in the to find out the beta L for the Grashof number and okay, so we here use the L. Now fluid specific heat, so Cp, viscosity mu, and thermal conductivity K. So these are the MLT form of our variables. Now here how many variables? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, so total number of variables are 7. Now we find out the pi groups. Okay, so how to find out pi groups? So first we find out the total number of variables. So total number of variables are 7, and here we use the total 4 constants: mass, length, time, and temperature. So m equal to 4. Now n equal to 7, m equal to 4, so 7 minus 4 is equal to 3. So total 3 pi terms are developed from this equation. So number of pi terms are 3. Now what is our equation? So function of pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 is equal to 0. Otherwise we can write down that pi 1 is a function of pi 2 and pi 3. Okay. Now we derive the groups pi 1, pi 2 and pi 3. So here we made the equations pi 1. Now here we take the repetitive parameter, so rho density, which is depends on the flow property, L, which is depends on the geometry, mu, which is the depends on the fluid property, and K, which is depends on the temperature. Okay, so here we take total 4 parameters, which are the repetitive parameters. So you can see that in pi 1, pi 2 and pi 3, total these 4 parameters are same: rho, L, mu and K. Now here raised to, so A1, B1, C1, D1, here raised for pi 2 terms, raised to are A2, B2, C2, D2, for pi 3, A3, B3, C3 and D3. Now here, so how many parameters is remaining? H, Cp and beta, delta, G. So one time we write down the H in pi 1 terms, Cp in pi 2 terms and beta G delta T in pi 3 terms. So we have to find out here pi 1, pi 2 and pi 3 equations. Now we first solve the pi 1 terms. So find out the pi 1 terms. Now here I have to write down this pi 1 terms. So simple, here we put the MLT forms in these parameters. So this one the rho, then L, mu, K and F. So here we keep the MLT form. Now we expansion of the MLT means we compare the power of this in left hand side and right hand side. So first we compare the power of M. So in M we can write down M. So A1 plus C1 plus D1 plus 1. Now for L. So for L, minus 3A1 plus D1 minus C1, okay, plus D1. So this one for compare M, this one L. Now for T. So T 0 is equal to, what is the here? So minus C1 minus 3D1 and minus 3, okay. Then here theta, so theta is a minus d1, right, this one minus d1 and minus 1. So these 4 are the compare the powers. Now we solve this equation. So here we know that d d1 is equal to minus 1. Okay, now put this value in this equation. So minus 3 minus 1, 3, 3 minus 3, 0. So c1 is equal to 0. Now c1 is equal to 0 and d1 is equal to minus 1. So here this one 0, minus 1 plus 1 cancel. So a1 is also 0. Then here we put the values of a1 is equal to 0, c1 is equal to 0, d1 is equal to minus 1. So we can find out d a1. So minus 3a1 minus b1 is equal to 1 and minus 1, so both are 0. So here b1 is equal to 1. Okay, now what is the pi1? So pi1 is equal to, here we keep the value, so rho a1, rho raised to 0 means this product will be 0, l raised to 1, so here we can write down l, then mu raised to 0, so no write down, then d1, which value is 1. So k raised to minus 1. So k is a divided of l, right? And then as it is h. So our equation is pi1 terms is hl upon k. Now we go to the solve the pi2 terms. So now in pi2 terms, again here compare the MLT powers. Pi2 here, rho, l, mu and k are the repetitive variables, and here we adding new variable is Cp, specific heat. Here we keep the all MLT forms of these four parameters. Now we compare the power of the m. First we compare power of the m. So 0 is equal to a2 plus c2 plus d2, right? Then for l, 0 is equal to minus 3a2 plus b2 minus c2 plus d2 minus 2, l square, so plus 2. Now for t, 0 is equal to minus c2 minus 3d2 minus 2, and for theta minus minus d2 minus 1. So here d2 is equal to minus 1. Okay, now d2 is equal to minus 1, so minus 3 minus 1 plus 3, plus 3 minus 2 1. So c2 is equal to 1. Now d2 is equal to minus 1, c2 is equal to 1. Okay, so here c2 and d2, so 1 minus 1 is cancelled, so a2 is equal to 0. Now these values insert in this equation, and b2 is equal to also 0. Now we keep the value of power in this equation. So rho raised to 0 means 1, l raised to 0 means 1. Now mu, so this one mu, k divided by k, and our last parameter is Cp. So this is the pi2 terms. Okay, now we go in the third. So third is a derived the pi3 terms. So find out the pi3 terms. Now in pi3 terms, here again, so here simple, we write down the MLT form of this pi3 terms, right? These three are the, four are the repetitive, and here new parameter is beta g delta t, which dimensions is minus lt, lt minus 2, right? So here we compare m power, l power, t power and theta power, then again simplify this. So here d3 is equal to 0, right? Then d3 is equal to 0, so this parameter is 0, minus 2, so c3 is equal to minus 2. Then we put the value of c3 and d3 in this equation, right? So a3 is equal to 2, and we put these all values in this equation, so b3 is equal to this one. Now here pi3, so now for here we keep the values. Okay, so rho raised to a3, so we can write down rho raised to a3 means square, then l raised to 3, then mu raised to minus 2, and last our parameter beta g delta t. Okay, this is the our equation. Now here rho upon rho upon mu square is equal to nu square. So here we put the value of nu square. Okay, so this is the pi 3 terms. Now we solve the pi equation. So what is the pi equation? It is a function of pi 1, pi 2, pi 3 is equal to 0, means pi 1 is function of pi 2 and pi 3. Okay, now here we put the value. Pi 1 is equal to hl by k, pi 2 is equal to mcp by k, and pi 3 is equal to beta g delta t l cube by nu square. Now hl by k is a Nusselt number, mu cp by k is a Prandtl number, and rho square beta g delta t l cube by mu square is equal to Grashof number. So here we can write down this Nusselt number is a function of pi 2 means Prandtl number and pi 3 means Grashof number. Okay. Now mu is a function of Prandtl number and Grashof number. Product of the Prandtl number and Grashof number is a Rayleigh number Ra. Okay, and here m and n both are the constant as per the difference of the temperature. Thank you.